John the Baptist taught, the teacher of the disciples, the apostles taught. Not what theologians will teach you, because that's just a slave doctrine. Christianity is just a slave religion. That's what they use against you to keep you in servitude. That's what they use to subdue you, to control you. Somehow we forgot all about that. It's been a couple hundred years and a couple of different generations, and all of a sudden everybody think that this is the true religion on the earth. Christianity is garbage. But we come today to teach you the truth according to this Bible. Read what you got. Ezekiel chapter 3, verse 17. Because the Most High sent us out here to you. Why? Because the people that have sent themselves to you, that ordained themselves as ministers and bishops and deacons and pastors and apostles, nobody said that they could be apostles. Wicked men said that they could be apostles. And then you accept them as apostles, and they teach you twisted scriptures, out of context verses. You better listen closely for your own good. Read. Ezekiel chapter 3, verse 17. Son of man, I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel. Therefore, have the word at my mouth, and give them warning from me. So that's what we're doing. We're giving you warning from the Most High. Whether you hear it or whether you forbear it, that's up to you. I really don't care. Give me Revelations 14. I think it's 12. Yesterday, to do the commandments and the faith of Christ. I really don't care if you hear or forbear. The word is what the word is. If you don't like it, then you just be destroyed when Christ returns. It's not a game. You see these brothers out here? We keep God's commandments in the faith of Christ. That's what's commanded of us. Read what you get. Revelation chapter 22 and verse 14. Blessed are they that do his commandments. Blessed are they that do what? That do his commandments. No, blessed are they that go to church every day on Sunday at 11 o'clock service for praise and worship. Blessed are they that do his commandments. Blessed are they that listen to what their pastors say, say that they repent and that they are born again, get baptized, and do the whole wicked thing that they do every week. Blessed are they that do his commandments. Read about the commandments, but don't really do them. Blessed are they that do his commandments. Only believe in Christ. Blessed are they that do his commandments. You know how many commandments there are? There are over 600 commandments in the Bible. The 10 commandments that you know about are just a summation of all the commandments. Thou shalt not bear false witness. That goes into lying. That goes into slander, into gossip, into tale-bearing. That goes into your false pastors and preachers, your deacons and ministers. That's what that goes into. Thou shalt not kill. That goes into murder. That goes into hating your brother. That goes into rape. The Ten Commandments that you know about is a summation of all the other commandments in the Bible. Read that again. Revelation chapter 22 and verse 14. Blessed are they that do his commandments, that they may have right to the tree of life. That's the only way that you're going to get salvation. That is the only way that you can get salvation. Drop everything else you have, hold this, and give me Ezekiel 18:27. The Bible says, blessed are they that do his commandments, that they may have right to the tree of life. That's the kingdom of heaven when Christ returns. Blessed are they that do not know his commandments and don't do them. Not think about the commandments and don't do them. You have to do the commandments and believe in Christ. Read what you got.
Ezekiel 18:37.
Ezekiel chapter 18 and verse 27. Again, when the wicked man turneth away from his wickedness. What is a wicked man? What What does the Bible mean when it says wicked? The Bible means that this person breaks God's commandments. They don't do nothing Christ said. They only believe in Christ. They don't do anything. Leviticus 11 says you should not eat conch, you should not eat crab. You should not eat lobster, you should not eat shrimp. You should not eat pork. Christ taught these things. Christ, Peter, they did not do any of these things. They did not eat any of those unclean animals. But what do you do? I believe in Jesus, but I like this pork. I believe in Jesus, but I got a nice pot of crab and rice waiting on me back at home after church. You wicked as hell if you do that.
That's right.
You will die in your sins. We don't sugarcoat the Bible. We ain't doing what your pastor's gonna do. What the word says, we're gonna teach it. What the word says, we're gonna do it. Not talk about it. Not listen to it and don't take heed to it. Read what you got again. Ezekiel chapter 18 and verse 27. Again, when the wicked man turneth away from his wickedness. So when the wicked man turns from his sins, read, that he hath committed, and doeth that which is lawful and right. What is lawful? When a wicked man turneth from his sins and does that which is lawful, meaning according to God's laws, the 600 plus commandments in the Bible, that were initially given by who? Moses. And furthered by Christ and the disciples. Read that again from the top. Again, when the wicked man turneth away from his wickedness that he hath committed, and doeth that which is lawful and right, he shall save his soul alive. So when somebody asks you if you're still saved, give them Ezekiel 18 and 27. Because that person asking you if you are still saved, if he does not keep the commandments, he himself will not save his soul. He himself cannot save his soul. So guess what? How can he save yours?
Right.
If somebody is not keeping God's commandments, doing that which is lawful and right, how can he teach you the Bible if he himself is not keeping the commandments? Read it one more time from the top. Ezekiel chapter 18 and verse 27. Again, when the wicked man turneth away from his wickedness that he hath committed, and doeth that which is lawful and right, he shall save his soul alive. That's how you become saved, quotation. Because you're not saved until Christ gets back. You're still in the land of your captivity. You're still a bunch of niggas and coons if you ain't keeping these commandments. You got it? Romans chapter 2, verse 13. For not the hearers of the law are justified before God. So if you go to church and your pastor briefly goes over the commandments, and all you're doing is listening to them, you ain't doing them, and you ain't taking heed, or when you read in the New Testament, Christ says that it's not just the physical act of laying with a married woman, known as adultery. Now it's the thought of lusting after a woman. If you still do that, you wicked as hell, you're going to be destroyed if you don't repent. Those are the examples of the commandments, the 600 plus commandments in the Bible. If you don't do that, read that again. Romans chapter 2 and verse 13. For not the hearers of the law are just before God, but the doers of the law shall be justified. Then you will not be justified if you're not keeping God's commandments. It says the doers of the law. Not people that listen in church on Sunday at 11 o'clock, go home, and don't do nothing that they heard.
That's right.
And all of you do that. So don't think for one second that I ain't talking to you. I'm talking to you. Everybody on the street right now, I'm talking to you. You are wicked as hell because you are not applying this. Read that one more time for the deaf people. Romans chapter 2 and verse 13. For not the hearers of the law are just before God. Because we're telling you the commandments, and guess what? You still ain't gonna abide those commandments. You still not gonna humble yourself to those commandments. You still don't want to put down the pork chops.
Right.
Read that one more time. For not the hearers of the law are just before God, but the doers of the law shall be justified. So guess what? When people drive passes and say, preach, preach, right. Guess what? You better listen. I don't care how into the sermon that you feel, you better do as this Bible says. Because guess what? That's what being born again is. Give me that in 1 John. That's what it means to be born again. Not singing, dancing, and shouting. Not sitting in church every Sunday morning at 11 o'clock and not doing what Christ taught. Not following the footsteps of Christ, because Christ was perfect. He kept every commandment.
Read 1 John. I want 1 John. Book of 1 John. 1 John, where it says, he that is born of God. Read that right there. Verse 9.
1 John chapter 3 and verse 9. Whosoever is born of God. You think you're born again? We're going to find out. Read that again from the top. Whosoever is born of God doth not commit sin. Do you even know what sin is? You probably don't. You probably skip all over that verse. You probably even tore it out of your Bible. Because you're breaking the commandments right now. And don't even know it in your simplicity. You are breaking the commandments right now. If you just came out of Southwest Plaza and you got a shopping bag with you, or you've been buying numbers, or you bought a nice pepperoni pizza, guess what? You are a sinner. You need to repent.
That's right.
Read that again. Whosoever is born of God, you think you're born again? You think you asked God to forgive you? You think you have repented? You think because you go to church every Sunday morning that you're saved? We're going to find out what the Bible says. Read that again. Whosoever is born of God, born again, read, does not commit sin. He does not transgress God's law. Give me sin. We're going to show you what sin is so you don't think that I'm coming off the top of my head. We don't do like your pastors do. Everything we say, we go into the Bible about it. We don't twist scriptures. Read what you got.
1 John chapter 3 and verse 4. Whosoever committeth sin also transgresseth the law. For sin is the transgression of the law.
Sin is what?
Sin is the transgression of the law.
So guess what? If your pastor teaching you that, all you got to do is say, thank you, Jesus, I love you, forgive me of my sins, and you've made it to the kingdom of heaven, you dumb as hell. The pastor retarded. He don't know the Bible if he says that. All of you will die in your sins when Christ returns if you do not repent and keep the commandments. Read that one more time.
1 John chapter 3 and verse 4. Whosoever committed sin transgresseth also the law. For sin is the transgression of the law.
You see that? And this is the book of 1 John. This is after the death of Christ in the New Testament. A book or two from the last book in the Bible. So guess what? Who is teaching that? All you gotta do is say, Lord, I love you, I believe in you, forgive me of my sins, and I made it to the kingdom of heaven. You are wrong, I'm sorry. You need to humble yourself to the scriptures. You need to humble yourself to the Bible. You think that however you feel God should be is how he is? And you trust in your own thoughts? The scriptures say that you are a fool if you trust in your own thoughts. Jump down to born again.
1 John chapter 3 and verse 9. Whosoever is born of God doth not commit sin, for his seed remaineth in him, and he cannot sin because he is born of God.
Because he is born of God. Hey, I can need that in a second. Because he is born of God. Give me Luke 13. Actually, give me, drop down and give me Mark 7. Mark chapter 7 and 13. So now you gotta understand something.
Let me see that. Matthew 7:13.
So now you gotta understand something. If you say that you're born again, you shouldn't be breaking God's commandments. That's what the scripture says. It doesn't matter how you feel, it doesn't matter what you think, that's what the scripture is. You gotta humble down to it. Because let me show you something. Read what you got.
Matthew chapter 7 verse 13. Enter ye in at the straight gate.
That's what we have to do. Enter into the straight gate. Because especially Christians in Christianity, they love to say, I on the straight and narrow. But guess what? You're doing the exact same thing the entire world does. You celebrate Christmas every year. You celebrate Valentine's Day. That's idolatry. You're following other gods, false gods.
the Lord told you to keep the Sabbath day holy, what you doing today? You're buying and selling. You're doing your pleasure. That's not keeping the Sabbath day holy. Sunday is not the Sabbath day. Sunday is the first day of the week according to the calendar. Read that one more time.
Matthew chapter 7 verse 13. Enter ye in at the straight gate.
So we have to enter in at the straight gate. That's the straight and narrow. What does that mean? Does that mean I got to go to church every Sunday? That's the straight gate?
Give me 2nd Ezra. Part 4.
Is that what the straight gate means? The straight and narrow path that we're supposed to be walking on. Does that mean that all I got to do is say, thank you, Jesus, for waking me up this morning and I on the straight and narrow? Let's find out what that means. We're going to go straight to the Bible. 2nd Ezra 7:21. We're going to figure out what the straight gate is talking about.
2nd Ezra chapter 7, verse 21. For God hath given straight commandments.
Spell the word.
S-T-R-A-I-T.
That's straight commandment. So now what does that mean? Read it one more time and then go back to Mark. Matthew.
For 2nd Ezra chapter 7, verse 21. For God has given straight commandments.
So God has given us straight commandments. His laws, his statutes, his commandments. Those are straight commandments.
Read Matthew.
Matthew chapter 7 verse 13. Enter ye in at the straight gate.
Sounds straight.
S-T-R-A-I-T.
That's the same word we just read about the straight commandments. Why? What does that mean?
That means being on the straight path is keeping God's commandments.
That's what that is telling you. So what is your pastor talking about that you don't have to keep God's commandments because Christ died so that we could be sinners? That makes no sense. How Christ died because you... How can you say that Christ died because you kept sinning so that you can keep sinning? Does that make sense? Think about that. That would mean that his dying was for naught. That means he died for no reason.
Read that again.
Matthew chapter 7 verse 13. Enter ye in at the straight gate. For wide is the gate and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction.
So guess what? You're going to church tomorrow. You just celebrated Independence Day. You celebrate the false holidays of this world. Guess what? You are not on the straight and narrow path.
That's right.
You are in the wide gate, which leads to what?
Which leadeth to destruction.
You're going
to
be destroyed when Christ returns if you don't repent. If you don't stop breaking his commandments. We ain't sugarcoating this Bible. We're going to teach you as it is written. Your pastors, they all they want is their tithes in them. That's all they want. And guess what? When you actually read the Bible in Deuteronomy chapter 14, quick, write that down. Go read it. Tithing was never money. So guess what? Who changed the truth of God into a lie? Who then said, you know what? Instead of tithing being lamb and wine and corn and all this stuff, you know, we can make it money. Let's make tithing money. Who said that? Who did that? Because guess what? You are adding to the words of God. You are a liar, a false prophet. That's not what tithing is according to the Bible. Tithing was always 10% of your crops, your lamb, your oxen, your corn, your wine. Why? Because you had the Levites that had no inheritance. They had no means of making money. Why? Because they were always in the temple sacrificing for our sins.
Right.
That's what tithing is. Not giving 10% of your check to the pastor. Now you can give alms to the church to help the poor, not to pay the pastor. It's to help the poor among your people. You see poor people walking on the streets, we're supposed to have the mentality. This is according to the commandments, mind you. This is how you love your brother. Not giving him lollipops and hugs and kisses. That's not what loving your brother means. Loving your brother means keeping the commandments. Not gossiping. Not slandering. Not deceiving him. not charging him more than it's supposed to be. If you say you're going to build him a fence, but the regular rate is $50, you're not going to charge him $100. That's a sin. Read Matthew 7 again.
Matthew chapter 7, verse 13. Enter ye in at the straight gate.
We already know that the straight commandments means that you are on the straight and narrow path in the straight gate. Read on.
For wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction.
So guess what? If you had crab and rice this weekend, you are on the path that leading to destruction. Read on.
And many there be which go thereat.
Many there be that go there. There's many people on the narrow, on the wide gate and the wide path that leads to destruction. So now you need to start reevaluating yourself. You need to start thinking, if everybody on the same path that I'm following, then I probably ain't on the right path. That's what you need to be considering. Read that again. If everybody keeping Christmas, if everybody celebrating birthdays, if everybody eating crab and rice, shrimp, if everybody doing the same things that the world do and not according to what God said to do, then you need to start reevaluating what you are doing, what path you are on. Read that again.
For wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction, and many be there which go in thereat.
And there's many people on this wide path. There's few people on the straight path. There's few people keeping God's commandments, not just talking about them, not just singing and shouting in the church, not just listening to what pastor goes on the other end. You don't do nothing that the Bible says. I can be straight with you. If you're still going into the Christian churches, you're on the wide path.
That's right.
That leads to destruction. I can be straight with you because they don't teach anything the Bible teaches. They teach a slave doctrine, a commercialized doctrine. They don't teach the doctrine of the Bible. Give me Proverbs 4:2. I'm going to prove that to you. What is the doctrine of the Bible? What is God's doctrine? What did Christ teach? What did Paul teach? What did Peter teach? What did John the Baptist teach? What did Isaiah teach? We're going to show you. Proverbs chapter 4, verse 2.
Proverbs chapter 4 and verse 2. For I give you good doctrine.
And guess what? Who wrote Proverbs? Solomon, the wisest king of Israel. So he knows something that you don't know. Read that again.
For I give you good doctrine. Forsake ye not my law.
That's the doctrine of the Bible. That's the doctrine that John the Baptist taught. That's the doctrine that Christ taught. Read that again.
For I give you good doctrine.
What's that word?
Good doctrine.
This is what you should be learning in church. Read that again.
For I give you good doctrine. Forsake ye not my law.
That's the doctrine, God's commandments. He tells you to do something, you do it. You don't say, well, I don't feel like I can't do that because I can't be perfect. No. If he tells you to do something, that means you can do it. If you can do all things through Christ that strengthen you, guess what? You can do his commandments. You're just a bunch of hypocrites. You profess the Bible, don't do nothing Christ said. You profess the Bible, you don't even walk like Christ walked.
Right.
He was perfect. So if you ain't at least trying to be, give me James 3:2. We're going to show you what it means to be perfect. Because you think when I say perfect, you think I can run the fastest, I look the best, I'm the smartest in class, I can do all things to the best of my ability. That's not what being perfect means. Let's get that.
James chapter 3 and verse 2. For in many things we offend all.
Because we were born with a sinful nature. Read that again.
For in many things we offend all. If any man offend not in the word, the same is a perfect man. If any man offend not in word,
you know what that means? You follow the commandments. If you don't offend this Bible, but it's written therein. Read that again.
James chapter 3 and verse 2. For in many things we offend all. If any man offend not in word, the same is a perfect man, unable also to bridle the whole body.
Meaning that you are able to humble yourself to the scriptures. The Bible says that
eating crab and rice is an abomination because that's unclean food. Crab is unclean food. If it does not have fins and scales, right, it is unclean to you. So that lovely looking shrimp on your plate, guess what? It's unclean food. Why would you want to eat something that cleans up the ocean floor?
Right.
If you have a fish tank, and you have a filter. When you clean out the fish tank and you look at that filter, you see how disgusting that filter looks. You see how unclean that filter is. Guess what? That's exactly what's inside that shrimp. That's exactly what's inside that crab. Because they clean the ocean floor. So why would you want to put something unclean in you? Read that one more time.
James chapter 3 and verse 2. For I may things we offend all. If any man offend not in word, the same is a perfect man.
So this is what it means to be perfect. Read on.
And able also to bridle the whole body.
Able to humble yourself to what God says. So now that you know that shrimp, crab, lobster, any seafood that has, that does not have fins and scales, if you're eating that, you need to humble yourself to the commandment and put it away. The pork chop, you need to put it away. Because Christ did not eat that. And kill and eat don't mean that you can kill whatever you see and eat it. Then you might as well eat dog. You might as well fry your cat.
Go back to what we had before, that. Matthew 7. Matthew chapter 7, verse... Start at 13 again.
Matthew chapter 7 verse 13. Enter ye in at the straight gate, for wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction, and many there be which go thereat. Verse 14. Because straight is the gate, and narrow is the way which leadeth unto life, and few there be that find it.
Only a few people are going to find it. That's why while you're driving by right now, you're listening to the word of God. Believe that. We teach you as it is written, straight from the scripts. We don't sugarcoat the gospel. But guess what? You still won't repent and keep his commandments. That's the unfortunate part. That's why there's few that find the straight path. Read that verse again.
Verse 14. Because straight is the gate, and narrow is the way which leadeth unto life, and few there be that find it.
There's only a couple of us that's going to find these commandments, that's going to realize that, guess what, I need to repent because I've been cooking crab and rice this weekend and I loved it, and now I know that it's an abomination. That's what it means to be born again. That's what it means to be, to save your soul alive, like we read in Ezekiel 18. Read on.
Verse 15, beware of false prophets.
And that's what you now need to do. Because guess what? If they ain't teaching you according to God's laws, statutes, commandments, guess what? Read that again.
Beware of false prophets.
That means you're learning from a false prophet. If he's not telling you, give me Revelation 14 and 12. If he's not teaching you to keep God's commandments in the faith of Christ, and that person is a false prophet.
Read.
Revelation chapter 14 verse 12. There is the patience of the saints. There are they that keep the commandments of God.
No, just talk about them.
There are they that keep the commandments of God.
Just read about
them. There are they that keep the commandments of God.
Sing about them.
There are they which keep the commandments of God. And the faith of Jesus.
And what?
And the faith of Jesus.
No, just talking about Jesus.
And the faith of Jesus.
So you gotta keep the commandments and believe in Christ. So what's your pastor talking about? This is the book of Revelation. The last book in the Bible. We're just a couple of chapters from being done with the whole Bible. What is your pastor talking about? You got some questions to ask your pastor. You need to show him this verse and ask him, what's going on here? Read that one more time.
Revelation chapter 14 and verse 12. Here is the patience of the saints. Here are they that keep the commandments of God. say that keep God's commandments. Not just talk about them, not read about them, not know about them. You gotta do them. You gotta keep them.
You're simple as hell if you don't keep the commandments. Go back to Matthew. Go give me Luke 13:24.
Luke chapter 13 verse 24. Strive to enter in at the straight gate. For many, I say unto you, will seek to enter in and shall.
That's why you go to church every Sunday, because you want to make it to the kingdom of heaven. But guess what? Unless you're keeping God's commandments, you will not find the straight gate. Read that again. That's why the Bible said there's few that make it in there. There's few that make it in at the straight gate. That's the gate that you need to be in. That's the path that you need to be walking.
But guess what? Only a couple are going to be there.
Why? Because there's only a couple that's going to keep God's commandments. That's going to keep his laws. Not just talk about them. Not just sit in church every Sunday morning at 11 o'clock for praise and worship. And listen to somebody that's given a slave doctrine. A slave religion. Read that again.
Luke chapter 14 and verse 24. Strive to enter in at the straight gate. For many, I say unto you, will seek to enter in, and shall not be able. Verse 25. When once the master of the house has risen up, and has shut the door.
That's talking about Christ. Once Christ returns, and this is just, he's just painting the picture, because there ain't going to be no talking when Christ returns. There's just going to be killing and destruction. Read that again.
Verse 25. When once the master of the house has risen up and hath shut to the door.
So when Christ comes back and he closed that door, read.
And ye begin to stand without.
And you're standing outside that door because you want to be in the door. If you're standing, when you're standing outside, read.
And to knock at the door, saying, Lord, Lord, open unto us. And he shall answer and say unto you, I know you not.
He's going to say, I don't know you. Why? Because you ain't been keeping his commandments. Read on.
I know you not whence ye are. Then shall he begin to say, we have eaten and drunk it in thy presence.
But Lord, we've been holding these feasts. We celebrated your birthday on December 25th. Read that again.
And then shall begin to say, we have eaten and drunk it in thy presence, and thou hast taught in our streets.
And we've been teaching, we have churches. I was a deacon, I was an apostle.
Read. Verse 27. But he shall say, I tell you, I know you not whence ye are.
He can tell you, I don't know you. Why? Because they ain't keeping none of his commandments. Instead, you broke them. You were a sinner and wicked as hell. You did not repent in the faith of Christ. You did not even try to keep the commandments.
Read that verse again.
Verse 37. But he shall say, I tell you, I know ye not whence ye are. Depart from me, all ye workers of iniquity.
All ye workers of what?
All ye workers of iniquity.
That means you broke his commandments. That means you were sinning willfully. That's what that means. Go back to Matthew chapter 7. Read verse 21.
Matthew chapter 7 and verse 21. Not every one that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven.
Guess what? Just because you go to church faithfully, Wednesday night, Friday night, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, whatever day you go to church, guess what? Read that again.
Not everyone that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the...
Just because you believe in Christ, read that again.
Not everyone that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven. But he that doeth the will of my Father.
So now we need to know what the will of God is. Because I know you don't know. You ain't doing it right now.
Get that.
We're going to show you what the will of God is. Because the pastor didn't do it. Trust me, I know.
Read that.
Psalm chapter 40 verse 8. I delight to do thy will, O my God.
This is the will of God.
Read.
Yea, thy law is within my heart. I delight to do thy will, O my God. Yea, thy law is within my heart.
So if your pastor ain't teaching you what the will of God is, which is his laws, his judgments, his statutes, 600 plus of them, guess what? You are learning from a false prophet.
That's right.
Go back to where we was holding.
Matthew chapter 7 verse 21. Not every word that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven.
Just because you believe in Christ don't mean that you're going to get the kingdom. Just because you listen to Sunday worship every Sunday don't mean you're going to get the kingdom of heaven. Read that again.
Not every word that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven. But he that doeth the will of my Father, which is in heaven,
keeping the commandments. We just read that, Psalms 40 and 8. Keeping God's commandments is his will.
Give me 2 Ezra 7.
So guess what? And it's a sad thing, because guess what? Don't we out here preaching every Saturday? Many of y'all won't repent. One or two of you might. But guess what? It don't really matter. You know why? Judgment is already set. Judgment is already set. So if you're keeping God's commandments, just know that you're going to be in the destruction. Just know that.
Read what you got. 7-1. Psalm 7-1.
2 Ezra chapter 7 and verse 1. And when I had made an end of speaking at these words, there was sent unto me the angel which had been sent unto me the nights afore. And he said unto me, Up, Ezra, and hear the words that I am come to tell thee. And I said, Speak on, my God. Then said he unto me, The sea is set in a wide place.
So now we're talking about a beautiful ocean. It is set in a wide place. This is a great ocean, read.
The sea is set at a wide place, that it might be deep and great. But put the case of the entrance were narrow.
But guess what? In order to get to this beautiful, great sea, you gotta go through a narrow passage. You gotta go through a narrow way. Read that again.
But put the case, the entrance were narrow and like a river. Who then could go up into the sea?
So who can make this journey to the sea by going past this small river? This tiny river. Read.
To look upon it and to rule it. If he went not through the narrow.
So you gotta go through the narrow to get to the great sea.
Read on.
How could he come into the broad? Verse 6. There is also another thing. A city is built and set upon a broad field.
What is talking about? New Jerusalem. The city of David when Christ returned. It's talking about the kingdom of heaven. Read.
And it's full of good things. The entrance thereof is narrow and is set in a dangerous place to fall.
So guess what? In order to get to the city, New Jerusalem, you gotta go through a narrow place, which is dangerous. Read that again.
Verse 7. The entrance thereof is narrow and is set in a dangerous place to fall. Like as if there were a fire on the right hand and on the left a deep water.
So in order to get to the kingdom of heaven, you want a narrow path. One side is fire and the other one is deep water, which you can drown.
Pay attention. Read on. Verse 8.
And the only path between them both, even between the fire and the water, so small that there could not but one man go there at once.
Oh, let me give me Ezekiel 14.
So only one man could go through this path at one time. That's how narrow it is. That's how hard it is. That's why the scriptures say, the straight gate, only few can find it.
Ezekiel 14. Every man save his own soul.
We're gonna show you what it means that only one man can pass through this path.
Ezekiel chapter 14 and verse 14. Though these three men, Noah, Daniel, and Job were in it.
These are righteous men according to the scriptures. Read on.
They should deliver but their own souls.
They can only save themselves. How?
By their righteousness.
By their what?
By their righteousness.
Righteousness is keeping God's commandments. Deuteronomy 6:25. That's what it means to be righteous. Deuteronomy chapter 6:25. Make a mental note, write it down. Go read in your Bible.
That's what it means to be righteous. Read that again.
Though these three men, Noah, Daniel, and Job, were in it, they should deliver but their own souls by their righteousness.
So by keeping the commandments is the only way that you can save yourself.
I can't save you.
In Ezekiel 18:27, write it down quick. Hurry up, write it down. Ezekiel 18:27, that's the only way. By keeping God's commandments. That's the only way you can save your soul alive. Not going to church every Sunday, because they ain't teaching you the Bible.
Right.
They're teaching you what the white folks taught you to keep you in servitude.
That's right.
It's history. Use Google sometime. Just Google it and learn.
Go back to 2nd Ezra.
2nd Ezra chapter 7 verse 8. And one only part between them both, even between the fire and the water, so small that there could but one man go there at once.
So you can only keep the commandments for yourself. You can only save your own soul. We just read that in Ezekiel 14:14. Read on.
Verse 9. If this city now were given unto a man for an inheritance.
And we know that it's only for the nation of Israel, you blacks, Hispanics. You that came over here during the slave trade. That is prophesied in the Bible. Both the transatlantic and the trans-Saharan. But guess what? You ain't gonna learn that in church because they don't know the Bible.
Right.
Read that again.
If the city were now given unto a man for an inheritance. If he never shall pass the danger set before it.
So guess what? If he's on the wide path that leads to destruction, he will never get the kingdom of heaven. If you're not keeping God's law, statutes, and commandments, the 600 plus commandments, you're not going to make it to the kingdom of heaven. We just went over like 100 scriptures talking about it. If you want a revision of the class, see me after my sermon. Read that again.
If the city were now given unto a man for an inheritance, if he never shall pass the danger set before it, how shall he receive this inheritance?
How? How will you get to the kingdom by just saying, Lord, Lord, I believe in you. So what?
Right.
You have not proven anything to me.
Right.
You have not shown me that you love me. If you have a husband and wife, the man say, baby, I love you. He beat it the same night. Baby, I'm sorry, I love you. She forgave him. He turned again the next day, beat her again. Well, how are you showing that you love this woman? Because to me, it looked like you hate her. The same thing with Christ and the Most High. If you're not doing what they did and what they say to do, then you don't believe in him.
That's
according to the scriptures. We just read that in the book of Romans. You better pay attention. If you ain't keeping God's commandments, thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not steal, thou shalt not murder, thou shalt not slander, gossip, stop eating crab and rice, stop eating shrimp, stop eating pork, stop eating lobster. Women ain't supposed to be wearing pants because it's an abomination. God sees it as cross-dressing.
Right.
If you a sodomite, a homosexual, if you a whoremonger, you need to repent.
That's
you're
going
to be destroyed when Christ returns. And guess what? We study this Bible daily. We see the prophecies unfolding. Christ is soon to come. Make no mistake about it. You better understand it. And the sad part about it is, as good as I might sound right now, y'all still going to get destroyed because y'all still ain't going to listen.
Right.
Back, read on. Read that.
Verse 10. And I said, it is so, Lord. Then said he unto me, even so also is Israel's portion.
So that talking about you, black man, black woman who came over here on them slave ships, the Nina, the Santa Maria, the Pinta. That's you who came over here in slavery. It's prophesied in the Bible. You want to see it? Come and ask us. We're going to show you. We don't run from the Bible. Come grab a fly. You're going to learn something. Because whoever going to teach you tomorrow morning, they ain't teaching you a damn thing.
Verse 11. Because for their sakes, I made the world.
He did what?
I made the world.
He made the world for you, but you think you a Gentile. You think you lower than the nations. You think you a nigger. You think the ghetto is good. The Bible says we are gold. The Bible says we are the greatest nation of people on the planet. But you want to be lower than that. You want to be something that they made you. How? They put you in the cotton fields, they tell you, hey, this white man, that's Jesus. That's what they told you. Now you started to believe that.
Right.
Why do you think some white dude could go up in the church, kill 9 people, and then immediately after they forgive him?
That's right.
Bro, you just killed my old lady. I ain't forgiving you. That's not according to the Bible. You need to repent. Get your minds right.
Read on.
We're slow. Then were the edges of this world made narrow, full of sorrow and travail. Verse 11.
Oh, sorry, verse 10.
And I said, it is so, Lord. Then said he unto me, even so also is the Israel's portion. Because for their sakes I made the world. And when Adam transgressed my statutes, then was the decree that now is done. So when Adam sinned, by allowing his woman to control, to teach him the lies that's against what God taught, that God taught Adam. Read that again. Then was the decree that now is done. Then was the decree that now is done. Then were the entrances into the kingdom of heaven made harder because of Adam. Because he transgressed. Because Eve transgressed. Read that again. Because for their sakes I made the world. And when Adam transgressed my statutes, then was the decree that thou is done. Then were the entrances of this world made narrow. So now you gotta fight to get into the kingdom of heaven. It ain't easy like it was during the time of Adam. They messed it up for us. So if you're going about your day, everything all good, somebody tells you to do something that's not according to God's commandments, and you do it, you're not enduring anything. You're not going through any type of suffering. You are living a good life. That's why you're going to be destroyed. Read on. Full of sorrow and travail, they are but few and evil. Full of perils and very painful. That's why we got to be on the straight and narrow, and that's why only a few people can find it. You could, what's coming up next? Read on. Verse 13. For the entrances of the elder world were made, meaning during the time of Adam, right? Were made wide and sure. Were wide and sure. Why? Because Adam knew the commandments. He knew what was required of him from the Most High. But they messed up. Eve messed up and he allowed it. That's how he sinned. Read on. And brought immortal fruits. If then they had lived labor not to enter these straight and vain things. Verse 14. If then they that live labor not to enter these straight and vain things, they can never receive those that are laid up for them. Verse 20. For there be many that perish in this life. So there's a lot of you that's going to be put to death when Christ returns. Why? Because they despise the law of God. Because they do what? They despise the law of God. That's why. Because you despise the law of God. You can drop that now. Give me Acts 14:22, I think it is. Too much tribulation. That's it, right? That's why you're going to be destroyed. Because you despise God's laws. You don't want to keep his laws. That's why you're going to be destroyed when Christ returns. Read that. Acts chapter 14, verse 22. Confirming the souls of the disciples. This is how you confirm the souls of the disciples, those that follow Christ. Read. And exhorting them to continue in the faith. And encouraging them to keep the commandments, because it ain't easy sometimes. It's not easy sometimes. But for those of you that I'm looking at right now, that willfully break the commandments, the life you're living is easy as hell. You can do whatever the hell you want to do, and then you think that you can be saved. But you're not. Read that again. Confirming the souls of the disciples and exhorting them to continue in the faith, and that we through much, through much tribulation, enter into the kingdom of God. That tribulation is temptation, enduring, going through the captivity that we in today. But guess what? If you revel in that, if you love that, if you love going to the clubs and then going to church right afterwards, If you love getting drunk, getting high, all that stuff, you love eating that crab of rice, if you love celebrating birthdays and Christmas and Valentine's Day and Halloween and all that stuff, guess what? You're gonna perish. Because you despise the law of God. Give me Hebrews 2 and 1.
Hebrews chapter 2 and verse 1. Therefore, we ought to give the more earnest heed to the things which we have heard, lest at any time we should let them slip.
So you need to take heed.
Go to Matthew 26.
You need to take heed. To what? To God's commandments. That's the only way you can save your soul alive. Not by going to church every Sunday at 11. Not by just believing in Christ. Not by paying tithes. You can't bribe your way into the kingdom of heaven.
Right.